So I wanted to sort of talk today about what it really takes to prepare a pitcher, especially a starting pitcher. As the high school season starts to warm up here and we start to get going in Maryland, and I'm sure as it works farther up north, games starting this week, and you know, I've seen a lot of talk on Twitter about, you know, I can't believe coaches are having a kid throw 90 pitches in his first start. And while I agree that that's less than ideal, I think if, as a coach, you just have to keep in mind how much preparation and what the workload previously has been for that pitcher, that thrower, to know whether or not he can handle it, right? So, for example, a guy like me that's, you know, 5'6", 160, probably can't handle 90 pitches as well as a kid who's 6'4", 230 and in great physical shape can probably handle that stress and that workload a little bit better than I can just from a physical perspective, you know, physical standpoint. And also taking into account how much previous throwing has that player done. So if all you've done is had that player, for example, throw two 30-40 pitch bullpens and he's thrown an inning or two in an air squad or a scrimmage, no, he's not ready to handle five innings in an actual game. So understand that the previous workload for a player before we start to map out how many innings can he throw, what's his pitch count. If he hasn't thrown 40 or 50 in a pen, or hasn't been doing plyo care work, or hasn't been long tossing to add to the stress that his arm can handle, then no, he's not ready to throw 90, 95, or 100 pitches in a game. Whether that's, you know, the first game of the year or the 20th game of the year, it really doesn't matter. So that's where injuries happen, is when the capacity is way outdone by what the workload was, right? So there's two typical patterns where injuries tend to skyrocket in baseball. The first one is really at the end of the year, right? Guys are throwing a whole lot more. Just the sort of grind of the season starts to wear guys down. It happens. But the biggest one is right about now at the end of spring training, or right in spring training, or the start of the season, when guys are, or the capacity is here, and then games start, and the workload jumps way up, and guys just aren't prepared to handle that stress. And then all of a sudden, you don't have enough time for adaptation. You're just piling more and more workload on a limited capacity. That's where the elbow blows out. That's where we get shoulder tightness and fatigue. And then all of a sudden, it spirals down the road into bigger issues. So all I have for you high school coaches or any of you players out there trying to take advantage or trying to gain as much knowledge as you can to take ownership of your own program is just understand what your capacity is from your previous workload and try not to supersede it by too much. Yes, we need to advance it a little bit. That's how we grow. That's how we add our capacity. But when workload vastly outworks that, that's where we get into trouble. So that's all I've got for today. If you guys have any questions, feel free to reach out.